It's 2019 and one of the hottest products from the Google Analytics line is probably Google Data Studio. They have improved the tool so much over the last few months and over the last few years that I wanted to update our tutorial on Google Data Studio. Now I've asked Ahmad to come up with a quick overview video on talking you through the most important features of Google Data Studio, how to build a dashboard with it, and go through the general process of creating a dashboard and sharing it out to your stakeholders. Now, this is by no means a complete tutorial on all the features that are out there in Google Data Studio. This would take far too long, but we have a playlist on Google Data Studio where we explain certain features in more depth. So check those out as well if you're interested. But for now, we got lots to cover. So Ahmad, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. This is Ahmad from Siavak, and in this video, I'm going to give you a quick overview of Google Data Studio. Data Studio is a free tool from Google that allows you to connect to and pull data from different data sources like Google Analytics, Google Ads, Facebook Ads, or even Google Sheet, and then easily create visual reports to share with your clients, stakeholders, and team members. In this video, I'm going to show you many features of Google Data Studio as we create this awesome e-commerce reports together. Exciting, isn't it? Let's dive in and see how it works. This is the main interface of Google Data Studio. We can see our previous reports in the middle, and at the top, we can choose to start with a template or create a blank report. We are going to start with creating a blank report. The first thing we need to do is to connect our report to a data source. We can do it by clicking on Create New Data Source. Google Data Studio can connect to a lot of different data sources. There are free connectors available for Google products, such as Google Ads, Google Analytics, Google Sheets, or even Google BigQuery. And for everything else, we can use partner connectors. Partner connectors allow us to connect to many different data sources, like Bing, Facebook, Instagram, AdRoll, etc. For the purpose of this tutorial, we're going to hit Cancel and start with the sample Google Analytics data provided by Google. Click Add to Reports, and we are good to go. First things first, let's give our report a name. Next, let's add the header. We start by creating a rectangle, resizing it, and changing its color. Next, we're going to add a title. We can select the text, change the color, and change the size of the font. We can also resize the widget and move it to a better place. Now let's add some numbers to our reports by adding some scorecards. Scorecards are good for showing KPIs or key performance indicators, basically any number. I'm going to head to a style tab to give our scorecards a border and round the corners. Let's adjust the padding as well. And then I'm going to head over to the data tab and enable the date range comparison. So I'm going to compare this metric to the previous period. And here it appears. Now that we are happy with the scorecards, we can duplicate and create more. This retains the styling and the configuration for the data. The only thing we need to do is to change the metric. For this one, let's choose transactions. We can drag it over to replace the metric. Now we can continue this process to make more scorecards. For this, we'd like to have product detail views. Drag and drop, and we are done. Next one is revenue. And I'm going to change this one to show a compact number. Next up, average order value. So as we can see, I can just type in here to search for all the metrics that are available in my dataset. And then drag and drop them to the left to change the metric. Now let's create some room for our final metric, which is e-commerce conversion rate. I'm using my keyboard to move these scorecards around. And I can even Control C and Control V on my keyboard to copy and paste and create a new one. E-commerce conversion. Now let's see from which countries are we getting our revenue from. For this purpose, I'm going to add a map to the report. Now each shade represents the number of sessions, but we'd like to replace it with revenue to see which country bringing more revenue to our e-commerce store. And just to make it clear for the end user that what metric is being represented by this graph, let's add a title and call it revenue by country. Next, let's see some trends by adding a time series chart to our report. Just like the scorecards above, I'm going to give it a border and also change the radius of the corners. Let's decide what numbers do we want to show on this chart. I'm going to head over to the data tab and search for some metrics. I want sessions to be there, but I also want to see product detail views, product adds to cart, and transactions. Let's duplicate this and create another chart for revenue. Right click and select duplicate. Okay, so now I'm going to remove the metrics and replace the final one because I'd like to see the trend of revenue over time. But for this chart, I'd like to see how revenue builds up over time during this time period. Now we're going to duplicate this and create another chart to show e-commerce conversion rate over time. I'm using my keyboard to move this around. Just like before, we can head over to the data tab, search for a metric, and replace the metric on the chart by dragging, dropping the new metric over the previous one. For this one, however, I don't want it to be cumulative, so I uncheck this, but I do like to see a trend line. Cool, isn't it? Now let's add a pie chart to see the distribution between male and female users. Drag it over here, choose gender as the dimension for this pie chart, and we can leave the metric to be the number of sessions. I'm going to head over to Style tab because I want to move the legend over the top just to make some room for the next visualization we're going to create. Now let's use this space to create another chart and see which cities are we getting the most revenue from. For this purpose, let's choose the bar chart, the horizontal bar chart. Move it here, resize it to fit, adjust the size to make room for the name of the cities, change the metric to revenue, remove sessions, and change the dimension to city. Our awesome e-commerce report is almost finished. Let's see how does it look for the end user. Looks nice, doesn't it? But there is a problem. This report is static. The end user cannot interact with it. They cannot choose the time period or take a look at different segments of data. So let's go back to edit mode and add some features and interactivity to this report. The first thing we're going to do is to allow the end user to change the time period of the report. And this is done by adding a date control filter, just like this. I'm going to head over to the style tab and change some colors to make it visible. Now, the viewer of the report can easily choose the time frame for which they want to look at this report. Just like this. Now let's go back to edit mode and add some more cool features to this report. I'm going to select these all, bring them down to make some room for the extra features we're going to add. First, we're going to add a drop-down menu that allows user to take a look at traffic from different source mediums. This is done by adding a filter control to the report. By default, it's set to medium as its dimension, but we are going to change it to source medium. Again, we're simply dragging and dropping. Next, I'm going to duplicate this, create another one for device category, which basically means desktop, mobile, or tablet, and allows them to look at traffic only from desktop devices, or tablets, or mobiles. And finally, I'm going to duplicate again and allow the end user to filter by user type, which basically means, is that a new user or a returning user? Now let's view our report again and see how does it look. Now it's possible for the end user to filter this report based on any of these criteria. For example, they can choose to only look at desktop traffic, and all the numbers and charts will be updated to reflect the choice. Now that we created this awesome e-commerce report together, it is time to share it with others. Let's take a look at different sharing options we have access to in Data Studio. The first option is to download the report as a PDF file, and we can even protect it with a password. The next option is to set up automatic delivery of the report via email. So Data Studio emails a PDF version of this report to the email addresses that you choose on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. We can simply create a link to this report, or we can share it with other people just like any other Google Drive document. Just like a Google Doc or a Google Sheet, you can get a shareable link or you can share this report with specific emails. So as we can see, there are lots of options for you to share a report with the people who need to view it. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed today's video in which we learned how to use Google Data Studio to connect to a data source and create a beautiful, interactive, and fully functional report and share it with others in about 15 minutes. I'm going to post a link to this report in the descriptions so you can view it and grab a copy for yourself to play around with. To make a copy of the report inside your own Google Data Studio account, simply click on this little icon. That's it for today, and thanks for watching. Bye.
All right, so there you have it. This is a quick overview on Google Data Studio, how you can use it, and hopefully you know now if you should use it for building your dashboard. It's pretty easy actually, but there are some quirks of it. So I also encourage you to check out our playlist, which I've linked up right over there, which will show you a few more details of Data Studio and a few more specific details on how you can utilize the tool for effective dashboard building. And as always, if you haven't yet, consider subscribing right over there to our channel, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. See you in the next one.